Before I start, I just want to say this message is not for people who have already taken heed and taken precautions. This is for people who still do not understand that something is about to happen. I want to spell this out for you.
Well, look at the Chilean earthquake. You realize that it was so big it actually rocked the planet Earth. The axis of the Earth shifted 3 inches as a consequence of that 8.8 earthquake. The day is no longer 24 hours. It's been shortened by 1 microsecond.
You said there are 5 major cities that should be concerned.
In our lifetime, we could very well see one of these cities destroyed. We will actually see this happen, perhaps. San Francisco, Los Angeles, Tokyo, Mexico City, Tehran in Iran. In our lifetimes, we could see one of the great metropolitan areas destroyed. And remember,
completely destroyed?
Leveled.
Okay, guys, you gotta ask yourself why an astrophysicist is giving you a warning about geological changes on the planet, okay? Now look, February 27th, that's when the Chile earthquake happened, okay? I'll scroll down a little bit so you can look at this and see the map, see where Chile is. That's on the Pacific plate, that's the Ring of Fire. Now look at this. February 27th, 2010, astrophysicist. What's happening on February 27th? He said the axis of the Earth shifted. There is a perfect alignment of Comet Elenin and Earth. Do you see that? You got the Sun in the center, you got Earth right there. See where it is? And there's Elenin. Okay, that's your answer right there. That's why they have an astrophysicist giving us the warning. Look, here's the tectonic plates. He said Tokyo, San Francisco, Los Angeles, Mexico City, and Tehran. They're all on the edges of the tectonic plates. Okay, let's go back. This is today. This is earthquakes. Just today. Okay? Tokyo, San Francisco, Los Angeles, Mexico City. Let's go back. All right, let's go forward and see where the alignment is this year. Notice that the comet is getting closer to us. The axis shift is going to be greater this year. Does that make sense to you? I hope to God it makes sense to you. I'm sorry, but people are not listening to me, and it's making me very upset because I'm trying to help you here. All right, now look. March 11th is this Friday. It's coming into alignment. And it looks to me like it's in alignment around the 13th, the 14th, the 15th. That's this weekend. Guys, I don't want to curse and I don't want to yell. But that's what I feel like doing right now. I do not know how to make you listen to me. If you are in any of those cities that Michio Kaku has graciously warned you about, warned all of us about, will you please take your vacations? And I would even further say that even if you're living in any area along the edges of these tectonic plates, I would say to get out of there during these dates that I've just shown you. I also want to say that the New Madrid fault area is another area. It's not on this map. It's right over here, okay? There's been activity there lately. I would say if you live on the New Madrid fault, I would get out of there too. They're not going to just come and spoon-feed you this information on the news. They're not going to hold mass evacuations beforehand because they don't know when exactly it's going to happen. But they've been giving us these warnings, you guys. There's just one more thing I want to show you. This is Joe Brandt. He's a kid that lived in 1937, and he had a series of dreams about the Los Angeles earthquake, okay? Okay, he fell off a horse, and he was in the hospital. He describes Los Angeles exactly the way it is right now. Complete with that new screen they just put up a couple years ago on Hollywood and Highland. This could be real, this could be total bull, okay? It's up to you what you want to believe, but he's not the only one that has been having dreams about Los Angeles. I've had dreams, I've had visions, and there are millions of other people who've had dreams and visions about Los Angeles. Okay, and I just find it interesting that he says he felt like it was early spring. I just want you to remember that we've gotten this warning from an astrophysicist, and there is a perfect alignment of this comet. By the way, this comet, I believe, is the red dragon from St. John's Revelation. Please watch my other video if you haven't. There is an exact constellation and alignment in the sky in September that matches it. So, you know, whatever you want to call this thing, you want to call it a comet, you want to call it an asteroid, you want to call it a brown dwarf, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. It's causing effects on the planet. How hard is it going to be for you to just take a day and get out of the city on the 13th at the very least? At least pay attention to what's going on around you geologically. If you smell strange smells, if you don't hear the birds. We just had that mass fish death in Redondo Beach. I just showed you in my last video that there was a mass whale death just before the New Zealand earthquake. Okay, I don't know if they're connected, but you got to start paying attention to this stuff. There's going to be another shift of the axis, I'm sure of it. How big it's going to be, I don't know. But it's going to be bigger than the Chile earthquake last year. I'm sure of that. So please just get out of those areas. I'm going to leave you with that Battle Los Angeles film that's coming out. Because I just think it's interesting that they're showing meteors falling from the sky. Seeing as how Comet Elenin was discovered by Leonid Elenin. And Leonid means meteor.
Good Wednesday morning, 94.5 with the Surf Rider Morning Surf Report.
Hard morning, Staff Sergeant! Staff Sergeant!
We now know that meteors will land off the coast of different
cities. They gotta be parallel to the deck. That's the whole thing with these bars.
Okay.
Oh, come on, you guys, you're killing me!
Good luck, rookie.
A small cluster of meteors is predicted to enter our atmosphere.
Scientists are scrambling to try and understand.
Evacuations are now underway.
Two or three meteors just impacted. Oh my God.
Fall back. Fall back.
How many of you?
Five of us. Three kids.
We have civilians coming out.
Yeah, take them. We got no room.
Wait. Kids.
Sky.